फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रशांत कुमार। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल सोशियो क्रिटिक। व्हीकल्स, इन द व्हीकल्स वी हैव फ्यूल, व्हील, इंजन, एवरीथिंग वी हैव। हाउ सेफली इट विल गो, हाउ फास्ट इट विल गो डिपेंड्स ऑन द ड्राइवर। ड्राइवर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन, ही इज गेटिंग कंट्रोल ओवर फुल व्हीकल। लाइक दैट इन द मार्केट इकोनॉमी the driving spirit, driving force is entrepreneurship. Friends, today let us discuss about entrepreneurship, the second lesson of business studies of 10th standard social science. Let us start, friends. Today, this entrepreneurship, the meaning, let us discuss first. Entrepreneur is an innovator of new ideas and business processes. The person who is getting new idea and bring it that one to the market. He introduced that one to the society or economy, that person is called as entrepreneur. And actually, the entrepreneur, he possesses the management skill. And he is having the strong team building capabilities. He is a leader. The leadership qualities should be there with that entrepreneur. And he or she exercises initiative by organizing the venture. And wherever the opportunity, they will use it. And especially, they will get the answer for the questions: what to produce, how to produce, and whom to produce. And they will become successful. And he comes up with the new ideas for products and market or techniques. They will become successful. And the entrepreneur who pursues opportunity organizes resources needed for exploiting the opportunity and exploits that resources, they become successful. Example, you can see, friends, computer. In the beginning, computer means a new one. Mobile phones, washing machines, ATM, courier service. See, the new ideas. Yes. And ordinary shops, we know, at that time suddenly super bazaars came, malls came. See, different one, new idea that created activeness, dynamism in the market. That is entrepreneurship. What is entrepreneurship? A process of an entrepreneur who undertakes to establish his enterprise is entrepreneur. So that is entrepreneurship. Who undertake to establish his enterprise, that is entrepreneurship. The word entrepreneur is derived from the French word entreprendre, means undertake some activity. Okay. Next, we have to discuss about characteristics of an entrepreneur. See, entrepreneurship is a creative activity. It's a creative activity. And everyone who are in confusion or chaos at that time, they are using that opportunity, sensing the opportunity. Actually, friends, so you have to think this one. The person who is doing something, others will call him as mad. Actually, he is in the right direction. After a few years, he becomes successful and everyone appreciates that person. And he is a person who seeks opportunity and take calculated risk and derive benefits by setting up a new venture, which comprises of numerous activities. That is entrepreneurship. What are the characteristics of entrepreneur? Is a creativity. New idea should come. Creativity necessary That is a basic quality of and characteristics of entrepreneur. Dynamism, he should be dynamic, daring. And he should be able to take the risk. Team building, that's very important one. He has to lead the team. Team building capacity necessary. Those who have that ability, he can drive the spirit. Problem solving. Commonly, whatever the risk you take, problems are common. If you are able to solve the problem, you'll become successful. For everyone, problem comes. But who is able to solve the problem, they will become successful. Risk taking. That's very important. And if you want to become successful, risk is there, definitely. You should have that daring nature to take the risk. That guts necessary. They will become successful. Commitment necessary. They should be committed to the work. They should not keep their leg behind. Innovation. New ideas necessary. New thinking necessary. Everyone thinking in one type and this person think in different way. Then only. So how Vishveshwaraya, when he was the Job Falls, what we say, wow, what a beautiful scene it is. But he told, what a great loss of energy. See, the way is different. Scientists are like us only. Entrepreneurs are like us only. But their way of thinking is different. Leadership quality, important one. They should lead that venture. They should guide others. Achievement motivation. They have to motivate others to achieve. So motivation, very, very important one. Self-motivation, and they have to motivate others also. Goal orientation. What is our goal? We have to concentrate towards that side. So we have to do all the works towards achieving goal. That is important one. Goal orientation. Decision making. Very important another character. Decision making. Especially at the time of a problem, at the time of critical situation, what type of decision he will take, depending upon that he will become successful. If we get the, when we get the problem, at present we got the problem. If we get the solution tomorrow, it's of no use. And that's that time. So that is very important one. Presence of mind, what we call, that is very important one, become successful. Decision making, self-confidence. If we don't believe ourselves, how can we become successful? So our confidence, very important. Self-confidence, very important. These are very, very, very important qualities or characteristics of entrepreneur. Yes. So next we have discussed about functions of an entrepreneur. What he will do. He prepare plans relating to business. First of all, he will plan that. What business, how to do, and when to do, full. What, how, when. So he will plan that. Without plan, we should not go. And organizes factors of production. Here, factors of production, you know. Land, labor, capital, organization, etc. Factors of production. And here, he organizes, according to his plan, he will organize everything. First plan, then organize, then takes a decision about product. What product, how to start or produce, and how to produce, when to produce, where to produce, and which technology I have to use. And if I produce that, can we get market? How to market that? And then employment. Whether it is possible to get the employees here. So all these things he will decide. Then coordinates things effectively. Coordinating what everything. He has to coordinate. He has to bring together. And it should not go away. It should not be divergent. So like that he will arrange. Introduces new method into practice. There entrepreneur always introduce a new method. Regular method means. With others he is another one. With the 10, he is 11th person. No, a different one. He introduced a new method in the production. And with that, he has a budget of his concern. Within the budget, he will do. It should not cross the budget. Within the budget, he will do that. bears risk and uncertainty. Now we are thinking, we are planning tomorrow or the next year, the different situation. Because last year we planned, this year because of corona, everything upset. So in this uncertainty, he should be able to bear the risk. He has to think about that one in his plan. Direct business firm and ensures its effective operation. He is having the capacity to give the direction. Business firm will be directed by him and ensures its effective operation. He has to go through it. Regular observation necessary about the effective operation. These are the functions of the entrepreneur. Not only planning, not only organizing, not only introduce a new method, he has to observe. Continuous supervision, continuous observation, important one. From the beginning till the end, his work is there. Then only he becomes successful. These are the functions of entrepreneur. Next, we have to think about the role of an entrepreneur in the economy. In the economic development, what is the role of an entrepreneur? He promotes capital formation. Capital formation. Because of the new product in the market, we will get the market and we will get the demand. And because of the demand, our products will get more sale, and as a result we will get huge amount. So capital formation possible and provide employment opportunity. New product, demand will be more, production will be more, with that employment opportunity will be more, and helps to increase GDP as per capital income and per capita income, sorry, GDP and per capita income will be increased. Gross domestic production will increase because of the new production which come into the market, and per capita income increases because of employment opportunity. Person's income increases, total national income increases, promotes the development of industries. Industries will develop, and that product to produce that, many industries will be open, and related to that, other industries will develop and promote country's export trade. Demand will be there for that product in outer countries, and we will export that. Export trade increases, reduce concentration of income and wealth. Many people, they will get employment opportunities from the production sector to the market to the end, and everyone get income, and distribution of income is possible there, and enable the people to avail better quality goods at lower price. The new method is introducing their better quality good with lower price. So different one, no? That's why. So his innovative ideas provide the goods, better goods for lower price, and improve the standard of living because of employment opportunities, because of the quality good at lower price, standard of living increases. Okay, and for example, one example I will give here, construction of house. Recently observed, many methods came, and in Udupi, near Udupi, construct the house. Only the basement we have to construct, and according to that a plan we have to give, and everything they will bring within a day, they will construct the house at cheaper price it is, and wall, everything they will bring, the crane they will fix there, and house will be constructed lower price. So it is possible. Yeah. And so such ideas, the quality improved, no? Standard of living improved. Ordinary people, common people can construct a good house. Work in changing environment. Environment means here economy and society, every situation, everywhere it will change. The changing environment also the person or the industry is able to work. That's very important for the development of economy, and try to maximum profit by innovation. They will maximize the profit with innovation, innovative ideas, new ideas. These are the important role of entrepreneur in the economic development. Next, importance of entrepreneur. Why entrepreneur is important? Because stimulates the economic progress. Economic progress is in a slow manner, in the same speed. Suddenly, this entrepreneur, they act as a boosters, or they keep their leg on the accelerator and they increase the speed of development, speed of progress, stimulates the economic progress with their new ideas. Mobilize the savings of the public. Publics, their savings are there because of the new ideas, new product in the market, their demand increases, they will bring that money to the market to purchase that. That will go to the entrepreneur. He will expand his business. He will expand his industries. So it is possible. So savings will be mobilized. Stagnant water is not good. It's not clean. Same way money also like that. It should mobilize. It should move. Create employment opportunities. I told already. Promotes country's export. Yeah. Repetition will be there. Introduces new methods, innovative, new methods he will introduce to the market. When it is new, automatically everyone will be attracted towards that side. Yeah, ordinary hotel, suddenly Darshini came, and afterwards a dosa camp came. On the roadside, fresh dosa they will prepare and they give. How much rush there, the people rushing towards that side, and they like that. And cheaper with the quality good they are getting. See? Yeah? It is new method there. And increases national income. As a result, national income increases. Expand domestic product or market. Market will be expanded. Yeah? And introduce a new product to market. With the new method, new product will come to the market. So immediately everyone will be interested to look at that product. So when big TVs were then a flat TV came, immediately everyone rushed towards that side. Yeah. Many years back about mobile phone, cell phone, we don't know. Nowadays, everything in the fingertips. You can get everything. So like that. So with this, for the entrepreneur, so many opportunities are there with self-employment. Self-employment opportunities for entrepreneur. Here, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises is the offbeat of this change. And they will provide all the help. And which are the opportunities they have? Self-employment opportunities. Which are the opportunities? Let us see. Advertising agencies. See, the new one. And you know that one, advertising agency. By taking the, if they, one company, their product is, to promote their product, and they will give, they will introduce that, they will say about the product to the advertising agencies. They will create an advertisement for that product and they will call celebrities, etc. and shooting, etc. They will make and create one advertisement and give to the company. For that, they will get money. They will charge. So, advertising agencies, marketing consultancy, see, consultancy business, industrial consultancy, they will give guidance. Consultancy means equipment rental and leasing, Shamian, utensils. Or JCB. So equipment rental and leasing, this one, everything you will get for lease, everything you will get for rent. Yes, photocopy center, Xerox, what we call photocopy center, copying center, industrial research and development. See, industrial testing labs, these are all new one. Yeah, cyber cafe. See, nowadays a very famous cyber cafe. Yeah, installation and operation of cable and TV network. Cable TV very famous. Installation and operation of cable TV network. It's a self-employment. You will get the opportunity. Creche, baby care centers, and beauty parlors. See, self-employment opportunities for the entrepreneur. There, so these are the opportunities you have. Here, what new idea you will bring, that is important. If you create something new, see, commonly what happens, see, for example, one example I will give, beauty parlor. Suddenly someone innovated. So by looking at the trend, looking at the mental status or the mindset of the people, immediately they started herbal beauty parlor. Yeah, herbal means one trend is there. People like that one. Whether it is herbal or not, that is separate. So like that, one attraction. And customers will come more. More customers will come. So this is the new idea. Many opportunities are there. There which new idea the entrepreneur or the person use, then they become entrepreneur. Okay. So this is about self-employment opportunities. Then to start the business, new idea we have. But to start the business, to start the industry, we need capital. Money is necessary. So some important financial institutions are there which provide finance for that. Finance is the lifeblood of business, that's why. So which are the financial institutions? IDBI, Industrial Development Bank of India. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, NABARD. Export and Import Bank, Exim Bank. Small Industries Development Bank of India, SIDBI. Industrial Finance Corporation of India, IFCI. Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, ICICI. Industrial Reconstruction Bank of India. Commercial and other banks. State Finance Corporation, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation. Unit Trust of India, UTI. So these are all financial institutions which help for the entrepreneurs. Yeah. With that, if you want guidance, okay, finance we got. Some guidance necessary in the marketing, we need guidance. Or to establish how to organize, where to get the resources, all these things, guidance we need. At that time, promotional organizations are there. Yeah, to promote our business, some organizations, they will help. DICs, District Industrial Centers. Small Industries Development Corporation Limited, SIDC, National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC, Small Scale Industries Board, SSIB, Small Industries Service Institutions, SISI, Industrial Estate, KIADB, Khadi and Village Industries Corporation, KVIC, Technical Consultancy Organization, TCO. So like this, promotional organizations, they will help. Yes. So now, anyway, entrepreneur, we are saying now, we need some example, some models we need now. Yeah, let us look at the profile of some successful entrepreneurs. Among them, Dr. Pratap Reddy. Dr. Pratap Reddy, he started the Apollo Hospitals. And in the beginning, actually, when he studied medicine, at that time, for heart surgery, people, they have to go to Texas in America. It's very costly. Common people, they can't go there. But it's in America. At that time, he started Apollo Hospitals and provided all the medical infrastructure in India only. So then it became very famous. We can get the facility which is there in America. In India only we are getting. And it is having over 750 corporate hospitals now. The model lines throughout the country. So the Apollo Hospitals, Dr. Pratap Reddy started. He is an entrepreneur. Another one, Naresh Goyal. Naresh Goyal started Jet Airways. India's largest domestic airlines under private sector, Jet Airways. Yeah. And actually, after his graduation, he worked in a travel business. By 1974, he started look after a sales and marketing of foreign airlines. Then, at that time, actually, up to 1974, private sector has no right. They had no right to start airways. But Goyal, Naresh Goyal, took the advantage of the open sky policy of Indian government. At that time, he started Jet Airways and he became successful. See, seeking the opportunity means that one. Yeah. Then, Infosys, Narayana Murthy. You know about him. Infosys Technologies Limited. Narayana Murthy. Immediately, Sudha Murthy, very famous. About her, I don't have to say anything. Everyone know about her. Behind every successful man, woman is there. That is especially Sudha Murthy, the model. Actually, everyone should learn from her. So Infosys, he started Infosys in 1999, and this Infosys became the first Indian company to be listed on Nasdaq, National Association of Securities Dealers and Automated Quotations. And by 1999 it started. By 2006, the company employed over 50,000 people. And its turnover, you can't believe, $2 billion. In 7 years, just imagine. This Narayana Murthy believed in honesty, transparency, and moral integrity. They are the key factors of his success. So Narayana Murthy became successful. Then Varghese Kurien. I think you heard about Amul Milk. Very famous milk powder. He was the father of white revolution. White revolution means increasing the production of milk. Yeah. And he started Anand Milk Dairy in Kaira in Gujarat. And there Amul Milk, very famous one. Yeah. Another person, Azim Premji. Wipro companies, Wipro Technologies. Yeah. And actually, after his father's death, annual general body meeting, in that meeting, one of the shareholders advised this Azim Premji to sell his shares, but he took it as a challenge and he developed Wipro Technologies. And actually, now it is the largest independent research and development provider, Azim Premji's Wipro Technologies. Next, this person, you know, Dhirubhai Ambani or Dhiralal Hirachand Ambani. His father was a school teacher. Just imagine where he came up. Ordinary school teacher. And this person, in his young age, when he was going to studying at the time of studies, he used to sell bhajan books to pilgrims at Mount Girnar during the weekend. After doing his matriculation, at the age of 16, Dhirubhai moved to Aden in Africa. And he worked in a gas station as attendant and afterwards a clerk. Up to 1958. In 1958, he came back to India with the 50,000 rupees and started a textile trading company. Then see his luck changed. Under him, petrochemicals, telecommunication, information technology, energy, power, retail textiles, infrastructure services, capital market, logistics. See, many most enterprising Indian and entrepreneur is Dhirubhai Ambani. He became successful. Ordinary attendant became the richest person in India. Just imagine. Next. Ekta Kapoor. She was the queen of Indian television sector. I think you heard about Balaji Telefilms, very famous one. And she, at the age of 19, ventured into TV production arena. Yeah, best entrepreneur of the year 2001 by Ernest Young. Yeah, another one, Kiran Mazumdar Shah, Biocon Limited. She was the chairman and the MD of Biocon Limited. The Biocon is the largest biotechnology company in India. And she started this one in 1978 in a rented garage and faced many problems because she was a lady. In those days, very rarely the ladies, they will start this business. And she crossed over all entrepreneurial barriers and made Biocon a success. So these are some successful entrepreneurs. So why can't you think different, become successful? You have that capacity within you. Become successful. Thank you. Thank you very much.